How's everybody doing today? Welcome to Virtual Vascular Lab Technical Tip Tuesday. And to all our subscribers, we really thank you. If you haven't subscribed yet, just hit that subscribe button. You'll get notified anytime we upload a video. Well, the last couple of weeks, I've been giving you some technical tips to optimize a carotid duplex examination. We still got a couple more of those to follow, but actually last week I was doing a carotid study and I came across something you don't see very often. So today, let's talk about branches off the internal carotid artery. Say what? Is that even a thing? We'll just do a real quick review of the carotid bifurcation anatomy. Everybody's familiar with this. We have the common carotid bifurcating into the external and the internal carotid artery. The internal originates, of course, from the CCA. The majority of blood from the CCA goes into the ICA. Generally, it has no extracranial branches. There are a couple intracranial branches, the ophthalmic and the posterior communicating. The ICA actually terminates into the middle cerebral and the anterior cerebral arteries. Low resistance flow feeds a low resistance vascular bed. In contrast, the external carotid artery has multiple branches. In particular, the ones that we often see are the superior thyroid and the ascending pharyngeal. The external feeds a high resistance vascular bed, the face and the scalp. So this isn't the patient I did last week. This was actually from a good many years ago. I'm scanning this patient's mid to distal ICA, and I see what appears to be a branch. One of the first things I do is turn transversely to ensure that, in fact, that branch is off this ICA and not just another artery coursing close to the ICA. I can see it both longitudinal and transverse. So one of the first things I need to do is make sure I accurately differentiate the internal from the external carotid artery. Now, if I show you this image and ask, is this from an internal or an external carotid artery? I do see a somewhat of a low resistance waveform typical of the internal. However, look at the image. It does appear there's a branch off of there. So if I'm a betting man, I'm going to say, I think this might be from the external because there's a branch off that vessel. Now, while we always say that the external has high resistance flow pattern and the internal a low resistance flow pattern, we also know these can vary substantially. And I always tell people the best thing is to compare in the same patient. And when I do that, although there's a fair amount of diastolic flow in this external carotid artery, we can see a clear difference in the resistance. So I'm pretty certain the upper left is the external, lower right is the internal. And here's the same patient's left side. This person had a bilateral ICA branch. Pretty remarkable. So here's the patient I did last week. We can see a high quality image, what certainly appears to be a branch coming off this vessel. I assume that's the ICA. It has a low resistance waveform. What I'm going to do, turn transversely. Yep, I confirm that little branch coming off the internal. Over to the right in transverse, I see the external. No flow during diastole, a high resistance flow pattern, and actually multiple large branches arising from the external carotid artery. So I'm convinced I have differentiated internal from external, as well as confirmed in longitudinal and transverse that I have a branch coming off the internal carotid artery. I'm going to turn back longitudinal once again. Internal. There I see the branch coming off that posterior aspect, rocking into external. And back to internal once again. ICA branch. So it got me to thinking, what really is the incidence of identifying a branch coming off the internal carotid artery? So I did a literature search, and actually there's not a whole lot in the literature regarding the incidence. Here's one study I came across out of the European literature, and actually they summed it up by stating that the anatomical variations of the internal carotid artery are mostly asymptomatic and therefore only incidentally diagnosed, as very few of these patients were symptomatic. They looked at magnetic resonance angiography as well as computed tomography angiography of 253 patients. They found a single case of the origin of the ascending pharyngeal arising from the internal carotid artery, or 0.2%. Another study from the European literature that surmises that arterial branches do in fact rarely arise from the cervical ICA, and therefore the incidence has not really been adequately evaluated. Here was a 5-year retrospective study of CTs. They found a 0.49% prevalence. And in case you're interested in going to read a nice case report, I included this reference also from the European literature. And this is a very well-written case report about a 63-year-old male who had a variant of the superior thyroid artery, the occipital artery, as well as the ascending pharyngeal arising from the cervical segment of the ICA. There was a common trunk of the superior thyroid and occipital arteries. And I included this reference because it included angiography. And this is actually a patient that had bilateral occipital arteries arising from the internal carotid artery. And in fact, image A, the one on the left, actually looks pretty similar to the example that I showed you with the ultrasound. So, in fact, anomalous ICA branches do exist and occur. If you come across one, make sure you're confident in differentiating the internal from the external carotid artery, and also make sure you confirm that branch origin in both sagittal and transverse planes. Then, consider writing up a case study and brag to your friends about your fantastic find. So, I hope you enjoyed the video on ICA branches. They do occur. Keep an eye out. If you need any Category 1 CME, please visit us at virtualveincenter.com. And yes, we're actually expanding to include a lot more other than veins, so please check it out. Again, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, go out and have a great week. We'll talk to you next week.